रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट नागपुर महाराष्ट्र। सर पोस्ट ग्रेजुएटेड एट टीएनयू कैंपस कोयम्बतूर इन 2005 एंड ही गॉट बीएससी डिग्री इन सेम कैंपस दैट इज टीएनयू कोयम्बतूर इन 2010। सर जॉइंड एज अ साइंटिस्ट एट ICR रिसर्च कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर नॉर्थ ईस्ट दिल्ली रीजन परपानी मेघालय देन ट्रांसफर टू ICR रिसर्च कॉम्प्लेक्स फॉर नॉर्थ ईस्ट दिल्ली रीजन नागालैंड सेंटर जर्नपानी नागालैंड देन सर ट्रांसफर टू द ICR नेशनल रिसर्च सेंटर फॉर बनाना तिरुचिरापल्ली तमिलनाडु प्रेजेंटली सर वर्किंग एज ए साइंटिस्ट इन ए स्केल अट सेंट्रल सिट्रस इंस्टीट्यूट नागपुर महाराष्ट्र। सर गॉट मेनी अवार्ड्स ही गॉट डॉक्टर डी एन बोरतकर अवार्ड फॉर टीम रिसर्च फॉर ईयर 2015 एंड 16 बेस्ट पोस्टर अवार्ड ड्यूरिंग इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन बनाना 2020 एल ड्यूरिंग 22-25 February 2020 at Tiruchirappalli, Tamil Nadu. Best poster award during national seminar on conservation and the conservation of citrus biodiversity in Northeast region held during 18-19 February 2021 at Central Agriculture University Imphal. Area of association is germplasm conservation and improvement of citrus rootstock. Sir completed 10 research projects funded by different organizations like ICR, Ministry of Agriculture and Farm Welfare, Ministry of Rural Development, World Bank. Presently, sir handling 3 research projects. Sir published 21 research articles in national and international journals. 1 book edited. Sir prepared 7 training manuals. Sir published 18 extension folders, 4 popular articles. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Kumar Keti, sir. Now I request Dr. A. Thirugunavalle, scientist of food science from the Institute of Central Citrus Research Institute, Nagpur, to take the charge of the orientations to our students. So over to you, sir.
Okay, sir. Shall I take? So basically, which year students?
Final year. Yes, sir. Final year. So they have completed all the coursework and their away program, everything, sir. They are only left with tour. Only study tour program. So, but this year, because of and pandemic situations, we are carrying out the virtual tour.
How many students are total?
Totally 220 students from the College of Horticulture Bidar, College of Horticulture Bagalkot, College of Horticulture Sirsi, College of Horticulture Arbami.
All are attending.
Yes, sir. All are attending, but all the students are attending from the respective college seminar halls.
Okay.
Total 220. Yeah, 20, sir. So most of them are attending from the seminar hall. That's why only few are joined from outside. Other than these health issues.
Okay, sir. Sir, slides are visible?
Yes, sir.
Shall I start, sir?
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Respected Dean of respective colleges and my senior colleagues over there and my students, friends. So today I'm just giving an overview of our institute activities as well as how Indian citrus industry and what is our role in the development of Indian citrus industry. Just a short presentation, it may not give you in depth, but whatever the doubt you have, you can ask me after that. So myself, Dr. A. Thirunjanavel, scientist horticulture and working in crop improvement division. First, I will give just a overall picture of citrus in the world as well as in India. As you all know, you could have been read in your curriculum. So citrus is one of the leading fruit crops in India. Productivity wise, if you take next to grapes and banana, it will come. And almost 140 countries, you can find citrus, particularly if you take the 40 degree south and 40 degree north latitude in between, what all the countries are falling down. So we can find citrus. Of course, it is there in almost most of the countries, but commercial cultivation, we can find only in 53 countries. So Brazil, China, India, US, Italy, Turkey, they are the leading producers. So if you take India, we are the third highest in area as well as production in the world. But if you take productivity, now our average productivity is around 12 tons per hectare. This almost we are in 26th place, we can't imagine. So some countries like Turkey, Europe, they are getting 26 to 30 tons per hectare, but we are lagging behind only with 12 tons per hectare. So in India, again, if you take this, the third most important crop next to mango and banana. In citrus species, mandarin, sweet, and lime. These are the three topmost species we can in India we are cultivating. Although if you go for world, grapefruit, pomelo, other groups are dominating. But India, you can see only mandarin, sweet, and lime. These are the three predominant group. And some part of North India we can find lemon as well as in Northeast India. And some of the wild species like citrus indica, you can find garroils of Meghalaya, commercially used by the local peoples. And citrus megalocycarpa in Manipur and Mizoram, then some strain of rough lemon, particularly in Manipur. These are the some of the wild strains commercially exploited in India. So if you take in India, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra, Telangana, Punjab, these are all the topmost leading states, except Kashmir and Andaman. So almost all part of the country we are having citrus. So these are all the topmost leading states in India. And if you coming to the if you take the citrus, Nagpur, Madrin, Kinno, Kasi, Coorg, Mosambi, Satpudi, and Asylum cultivars, these are all the commercially cultivated. Particularly if you take central India, comprising Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, and adjoining Chhattisgarh, you can find Nagpur Madrin. Western world, it's completely Kinno, Punjab, part of Haryana, and part of Rajasthan. If you go to entire northeastern states, it's Kasi Madrin. Same Kasi Madrin, if you go to Coorg Hills, Darjeeling, they will call Darjeeling, Sikkim, little bit strain will vary, Sikkim Madrin. If you come to South India, particularly Karnataka, Coorg region and Kodaikanal region of Tamil Nadu, they are cultivating Coorg Madrin. Mozambique, again, it's a central India belt, Satpudi, Andhra Pradesh. Some of the sweet orange types, we have Malta, very less area we are cultivating in Punjab. Asylum, almost throughout the country, commercially it has been cultivated. These are the just a small picture of India. Then if you take the world, again I told, it go up to 40 degree north and 40 degree south, but 35 degree between north and south, the commercial area is occupied. If you take India, it's only sweet orange, mandarin and lime. If you go for China, it's mandarin and pomelo. Now grapefruit cultivation also has been increased in China. Europe, maximum sweet orange. If you go to USA, it's sweet orange, grapefruit and lemon. Go to Brazil, it's completely a sweet orange belt. What are the juice, packed juice we are getting? All the concentrate have been introduced from Brazilian industry only. This is a small picture. And if you take the world share, there is a unique cultivation between India and the world. If you take world, it's sweet orange dominates, particularly Pera, Natal, these are all processing industry. Entire processing industry of sweet orange, if you take, it's with the 2-3 varieties only. If you come to second only, mandarin will come. Particularly India, China, Japan, we are cultivating mandarins. Then Asylum and lemon group, it's occupying around 22%. Other groups, grapefruit and all, it's but US belt. Now China also, area is increasing under grapefruit. So these are all the overall picture of the world. If you take India, again I told, mandarin dominates here. You can see total area is around 428 lakh hectares. Mandarin, sweet orange, then lemon, lime, lime. Others include some grapefruit, pomelo. If you go entire Bihar belt, northeast, you can find pomelos in home gardens. Other wild species, it includes all. But productivity, production and productivity is also mandarin dominates, followed by sweet orange and limes and lemons. This is the scenario in India. And you can see these are all the commercial citrus species, mandarin, it's called loose-skinned oranges, sweet orange called tight-skinned oranges, acid lime, lemon, pomelo and grapefruits. So you can find the difference between the pomelo and grapefruit. Generally, pomelos are dry sacks. If you cut the fruit, it will be dry. Not that much juice will be there. The fruit vesicles are dry in nature. But if you see the grapefruit, it's full of juice. More than 50% juice you can find. And you see that solid core will be there. In case of pomelo, it's hard core. And mandarin and sweet orange, you can easily differentiate, but it's difficult to differentiate between pomelo and grapefruit by look wise. Only you have to take the section, then only we can find the difference. Acid lime, so throughout the India, we can find lemon. It's only Uttarakhand somewhere, around Delhi belt somewhere they are cultivating. So these are all the top commercial cultivars of citrus in India. Then these are all the other varieties. We can see pomelo, Now coming to the CCRI, I will give about a picture of about our CCRI. Way back during 1980s, there is a black fly problem in Vidarbha belt of India, central India. So the committee has been formed. Then they have decided that we should open on a citrus research station. So under IIHR, as a regional station, citrus research station has been initiated during 28 July 1985. And considering the importance of the citrus industry in India, the regional center has been upgraded to a new institute. So National Research Center of Citrus was born in April 1986. After that, this NRC has been upgraded to CCRI, Central Citrus Research Institute, in October 2014. So right now we have around 250 acres of land, of which 160 acres are under cultivation. Total gem plus we have 638, later on we will see. And recently we have opened one regional center in Assam, considering the importance of northeastern sector. So if you take the productivity in northeast India, it's far below, maybe 4 tons, ranging from 110 in Arunachal Pradesh to 4-5 tons in Assam. So very less productivity is there, but lot of scope that region. You can see that that is the one of the primary center of origin, our northeast India. After considering the importance that our center, we have opened on regional citrus station in Biswanath Chariali, Assam, under in the Assam Agricultural University campus. So what are our mandates? We basically work on basic and applied research and conservation of genetic resources, technology for production as well as shelf life and utilization of fruits. And we are also imparting training for various organizations. And we are collaborating with the national and international organizations for betterment of citrus research. And consultancy services on contract research projects between private parties. These are all our broad objectives of our institute. We'll come to what is the problem of citrus industry, how our institute took part in solving these problems, we'll just see. First thing, any good orchard and your productivity depends on your seed. So seed is the basic input. So we in India, every year almost 1 to 1.5 crore planting materials are in demand. So you cannot imagine that much replacement ratios that new areas are coming, and the replanting of already senile orchards also there. So we are in demand of 1 to 1.5 crore planting materials every year. Badly, we don't have any quality, disease free quality planting material. Most of the nurseryman, they will sow seeds in soil. They won't maintain that mother block because of cost involved. They are not maintaining properly. When they took bud stick from the disease affected plants, so they are carrying the disease. Ultimately, it will affect our production and orchard lifespan. Second thing, high incidence of pest and disease. Citrus is a crop, is like a baby, so a lot of pest and disease will come. It will affect both the production and as well as market value. If we are not taking any control measures for thrips and mites, when the maturity times comes, the fruit shape will be very badly looking, so it will directly affect your market value. Then poor orchard management. If you go northeast India, it's completely neglected. People used to call organic by default, but application of any organic menus also will not be there. Any interculture practices also not possible due to undulated area and high rainfall. If you come to central India, a lot of stress factors are there. Irrigation is the problem. Again, post-harvest losses. These are all the four major factors affecting the Indian citrus industry. Then if you see that Indian citrus map, particularly if you go to northeast India, I am telling only biotic and abiotic stresses, omitting the poor orchard management practices. If you go to entire northeast belt, iron and aluminum toxicity. So if you have more aluminum and iron in the soil, immediately that will induce the boron and zinc deficiency. Ultimately, your production will be affected. Then canker, due to high humidity, huge canker problem will be there. Phytophthora, tritisa, of course, recent part greening is rapidly spreading, it will affect the orchards. If you go to western part, particularly Punjab, part of Haryana, part of Rajasthan, soil are highly saline in nature, calcareous soil, so your productivity and the tree lives will be affected. Coming to central India, high clay soil, drought, mainly drought. If rainfall is very short, starting from July to August, only 2 months. After that, one or two spells you will get in September onwards, October, November, December to again June. So long spell of drought will be there, particularly during March, April, May, these 3 months temperature will go beyond 45 degrees Celsius. So high temperature induced drought, phytotheron greening, orchards are affected. If you go to Andhra Pradesh, again drought. Coorg hills, phytotheron is a very major problem. Go to Tamil Nadu, drought and canker. These are all the some of the major airborne diseases affecting the citrus industry. So now coming to our institute, CCRA is the nodal agency for citrus germplasm maintenance. Currently, we are maintaining 638 accessions, including exotic varieties, which includes lemon, some of the rootstocks, mandarin groups, tangerines, and the processing sweet orange varieties. And we have the collection of indigenous varieties released by state government, farmers varieties, then wild and semi-wild types, particularly citrus latif. Northeast is the rich genetic reserve of wild citrus species we have collected and we are conserving in the field. And semi-wild types, both wild as well as replaced by the farmers. So we all the species we are conserving here. What is the problem we are facing? If you take that species from Northeast India, they are all adapted to high rainfall, high humidity and rich soil. If you bring that particular species to the high temperature and high clay content soil of Northeast India, their survival is very tough. So over the years they will die. To again every time going collecting and again conserving is difficult. So now part of that our duplicate germplasm we are establishing in our regional center at Assam. So most of the wild species we have shifted there. Currently we are maintaining 51 wild species in our regional center in Assam. So same adaptive climate, they are performing better. So already told sweet orange, we have two varieties in India, Satgudi and Mozambique. These two are highly sweet in taste. So they are not at all suitable for our processing sectors because of the lack of acidity. If you take Mozambique and Satgudi, maximum 0.1 to 0.2% acidity will be there. That is not desirable for the processing. So we have introduced a lot of processing varieties. And acid lime, nearly we have 93 acid lime collections. Lemon, we have almost more than 30. Tangerines, hybrid types, grapefruit, we have almost 10. Pomelo, we have 100 plus collections, wild species more than 50, and lot of rootstocks we have introduced. Rootstocks released by our institute, released by IHR, and lot of imported rootstocks we are evaluating here. So already told, we have two field gene banks, one in Nagpur and another one in Assam. And these are all the other varieties. This is Mozambique and Satgudi. These are predominantly cultivating here. Jaffa, pineapple, Western Natal, these two are the introduced types. And some of other varieties, if you take Kasi Mandarin, I already told, see that the rich color of Kasi Mandarin. And if you mature type, if you go, the fruit skin color is complete orange in color. But Nagpur Mandarin, it will look like this color only, full orange color will not come. Assam lemon, it's basically a rough lemon called lemon in Assam. You can't find each and every household and each and every hotel you go, without Assam lemon, you can't find any dish. And Satkara, this is Citrus Magalla Satkara. Highly commercially exploited, but there is no commercial orchards, only from forest and as well as from the home gardens. This is highly exploited species. And Ada Jamir, which is Citrus Assamiensis, this is also one of the wild species and people are using it in commercial scale. Kichili, this is mostly used for pickle making, particularly in South India. And already I told, so now we have citrus genetic resources. So what is the use? We have to characterize all the germplasm already characterized. So apart from that, we could know which species is resistant to what. So why breeding is required? We don't have, predominantly we have two rootstock only, rough lemon and Rangpur lime. If you take any part of the country, only these two rootstock predominantly. Earlier Karnakata is there, Galgal is there, sweet lime. So they are all not perfectly matching for our Nagpur Mandarin as well as sweet orange types. Now it's restricted to only rough lemon and Rangpur lime. Both are highly susceptible to Phytophthora, citrus greening, citrus stratisa virus. So it is, we have in necessary to go for breeding. So nature has its own remedial measures for everything. Luckily we have resistant source. Trifoliate orange is one of the best donor parent for producing the hybrid rootstocks. If you see the history of the citrus breeding in world, only You can find a lot of varieties. They are all natural hybrids and mutants. Citrus, lot of chimeras and mutants will appear. You select the best type, propagate it. If it is uniform and stable, release as a variety. This is what that earlier done, because lot of seed earlier was propagated only through seed. So lot of variation they formed. Many varieties came out. In early 1800s, only grafting and cuttings came in citrus. So that varieties got stabilized. In controlled pollination, only early 1900s only, they went for controlled pollination. So these are all the different breeding methods we have used. General conventional breeding and mutation breeding. If you go to biotechnology, embryo rescue. Why embryo rescue is required? It's citrus is a polyembryonic crop. Immediately after sexual embryo is formed, after that new cellular embryo will form. So a lot of new cellular embryo will develop faster. By the way, your normal embryo will get affected. So we have to rescue the embryo after 3 months. Then protoplast fusion for tetraploid production of rootstock. Now almost 6, 7, 8 species of citrus already been genome sequenced completely. We know that specific gene controlling the specific character. So you see that markers available, select the parents, no need to wait for evaluating in 10-15 years, just go for marker assisted selection. We can speed up the breeding program. Then transgenics and CRISPR. Transgenics, it's look like easy, but it's very difficult to attain success in citrus. Now CRISPR technology came, and recently in US they have developed one cancer resistant acid line using the CRISPR technology. So these are all the options available for improvement of the citrus. Initial breeding objectives, when some 100 years back breeding started, only 2 are the objectives. Different varieties of fruits are required by different consumers, mainly seedlessness. So seedlessness is the major factor. Kinno may be is one of the finest introduction and a very good success story for introducing the varieties. Kinno is a failed variety in US because they attempted crossing for to develop the seedless fruits. So when Kinno is introduced by Dr. Bakshi during 1950s in Punjab, after evaluating, it became grand success. So it has maximum seed content, almost 23 seeds per fruit we can find in Kinno. These are all some other objectives: size, yield, quality, seedlessness, variety of fruits for different consumers, cold hardiness, flavor. These are all the initial breeding objectives. Recently, these breeding objectives have been modified. We need processing type varieties. So perfect blend, TSS acidity blend we need. We need seedlessness fruits, distance marketing with tight skin, then high juice content. Now again, it was refined to secondary metabolites. Again, pest and disease resistant varieties. These are all the new modern objectives. First, we'll go for introduction. So plant introduction, just introduce from any other country, or within country also you can introduce. There are 2 types. And what are the agencies in India? NPBGR is the nodal agency. Earlier, NPBGR, Forest Research Institute, Botanical Survey of India. These 3 agencies are involved in introduction of planting materials. Now, as far agriculture crops are concerned, only NPBGR is the nodal agency. If anybody wants planting material, we have to go through NPBGR only. So NPBGR will serve as a nodal agency. They will bring that planting material. They will evaluate in NPBGR for pest and disease. Then they will send to the concerned crop nodal agency. For example, citrus. If any institute want to introduce the material, NPBGR will introduce. Then it will come to citrus. So we will multiply through shoot tip grafting. Again, it will be relocated to the concerned institute, which seeks for the introduction of planting material. So these are all the procedure. First, we will procure by NPBGR, quarantine, then we will go for cataloging, evaluation for pest and disease introduction, then we will develop planting material through tissue culture, shoot tip grafting, multiply and distribute it to the concerned parties. So main thing is that we should know the donor, what material we need, which country is having the material, who is the agency for translocating material from that particular country. So we will, in NPBGR website, there is a form. We have to fill the form through proper channel, send it to NPBGR, and NPBGR will make necessary steps to bring that material. So these are all the varieties. Kinno, it's introduced from California, and whatever the Mozambique and South Kudi they are cultivating, these are all introduced varieties only and become highly successful in India. And recently we introduced Java, Valencia, Malta, Hamlin, Pineapple. These are all the introduction from different countries only. Allimo, Citrus Macrophylla, and this is another important milestone. As a germplasm exchange only, these different wild species were introduced from different parts of the world. So continuous evolution for different traits. So Allimo is having moderate tolerant to the Phytophthora as well as drought tolerant species. Then we went for rootstock compatibility with Nagpur mandarin. It combines very well with Nagpur mandarin. After continuous evolution of nearly about 15 to 20 years, 3 years back, we have recommended this Allimo rootstock for Nagpur mandarin in Vidarbha region. And 2010 onwards, we have introduced nearly 17 exotic sweet orange types. Earlier, it was easy to introduce the material. Now, due to intellectual property rights, it became very difficult to introduce the planting material. And PIU as well as CCRI, we are continuously trying to import the planting material. And see, these are all the introduction. This is Cutter Valencia, a sweet orange, perfect for your processing. And it's a late maturing variety. Mosambi and Satudi will come bearing and harvest in September, October. And particularly Cutter Valencia will become available in January, February. So we can extend the harvesting period. And this one is grapefruit, flame grapefruit, deep red in color, and more than 50% juice content. And pomelo, I already told, pomelos are dry sacks. We cannot find any juice content in pomelo. But particularly this US pomelo 145 white flesh types is not a thin flesh. And it's having far better juice content than other pomelos. And second thing, clonal selection. So citrus is propagated by either by seed or by bud stitch. Sometimes mutation will occur. So we can find, we have identified one such mutant. It's a seedless mutant. It's not completely seedless. Around 1, 0 to 2 seeds we can found in the fruit. If anything is less than 2 seeds per fruit, it's called commercially seedless. You can see how many number of seeds, almost more than 12 to 15, 16 seeds in common Nagpur mandarin you can find. In case of N4, this is the Nagpur mandarin selection 4, we have N1 to N74. So after evaluating for more than 20 years, we can found that this it's giving stable seedless fruits. N7 and another N74, it's a big size fruit that is also in a couple of years we will recommend for that one. And another selection, NRCC Asyl M7, NRCC Asyl M8. So you can see NRCC Asyl M7 is round and big size fruits, and NRCC Asyl M8 is cluster bearing in nature. These two varieties are now it's performing excellently in Vidarbha region. Every year we are the demand for these two varieties are increasing. And this particular year, we sold NRCC Asyl M8 particularly, nearly around 30,000 plants we have sold. In NRCC Asyl M7, nearly around 15,000 plants we have sold. So every year that that increasing plant demand is increasing. Earlier, this region is occupied by Vikram and Pramalini. Now slowly that Vikram and Pramalini is replaced by NRCC 7 and 8. And Balaji, particularly on the AP variety, it's also performing better, and demand for Balaji also simultaneously increasing. And recently, couple of years, last 2 years, PKM released by TNAU, that variety is also demand is coming, in particularly in Central India. If you go to South India, but Balaji replaced almost all the varieties in South India. Now, 90% area under South India in Asyl M is from Balaji only. And so these are all the our varieties. We have selected one NRCC Pomelos 5. You can see this slide. See, US Pomelo, it's a white flush. See the flush color. And this is our NRCC Pomelo 5. This is pink flush types. Grapefruit, of course, see that introduced variety, the richness of color. This is our NRCC grapefruit. It's selection from, it's a seeded grapefruit only. It's selection from our Northeast India. TSS wise, color wise, flame grapefruit is rich, but juice content and TSS wise, grapefruit 6, NRCC grapefruit is better. But if you take these two, NRCC grapefruit 6 as well as flame grapefruit in Northeast India, and flame grapefruit becomes highly susceptible to canker. So NRCC grapefruit is performing better in Northeast India. Coming to hybrids, now we have seen introduction and clonal selection. then hybridization. So this is the method we have to go for. Generally, it would have been studied in other crops, like it's a hermaphrodite flower. One day evening, one day before, you have to remove the stamens from that flower and cover it. And next day morning, take the pollen from the desirable parent, pollinate it, and again cover it. So this is the simplest method. Pollination is not that much problem in case of citrus, but the other problems are there. One is sterility. We have both female and male sterility para all there. Then self-incompatibility, this is one of the major problem. So most of the varieties are self-incompatible in nature. Cross-incompatibility also there. Polyembryony, this is one of the major thing we have to consider. Polyembryony is both advantage as well as disadvantage in citrus. When it is advantage, if you go for propagation of plants, if it is having sexual embryo, zygotic embryo, variation will be there. So we will not get true to type. So there you need new cellulous embryo also. In case of polyembryony, in citrus only polyembryony seedlings will grow. So it will be resemble to your mother, true to type. Almost 99.9% true to type will be there. Particularly for rootstock multiplication, this polyembryony is required. When it is creating damage, if you come for breeding, polyembryony is the problem. So initially, when you pollinate it, your zygotic embryo will form. Zygotic embryo will grow up to 90 days, 100 days. Then later on, new cellulose embryo started to form. Almost we have recorded 14 new cellulose embryo in single seed. You can imagine. Immediately they will grow fast. They capture all the nutrient and they will club. By the time your zygotic embryo will not get any nutrient, so your planting material will not germinate. The zygotic embryo will not get. So if you go for breeding, we need zygotic embryo. Badly, this new cellulose embryo will affect. So tissue culturally, you have to raise, then isolate that zygotic seedlings and grow tissue culture. Then go for primary nursery and secondary nursery. By this phase, the survival percentage will become very poor in field. And long juvenile phase, a high level of crop. So if you cross 1000 fruits, ultimately when you go for harvest, if you get 10 also, it's highly success. So you see that much amount of fruit drop will be there. Again, we can develop lot of hybrids. So each plant, see the spacing 6 by 6 meter, that much area, huge land area require, lot of manpower require, cost for evolution is required. These are all some of the hurdles. So generally we will go for 1 meter by 1 meter, very close spacing. We need only one fruit or two fruit. Just we'll check if it is rootstock, resulting progeny should be 100% polyembryony. Polyembryony rootstock is required. Because rootstocks are propagated by seeds, we need true to type. In case of cyan, whether it is monoembryony, polyembryony, doesn't matter. Anyway, it is going through vegetative propagation only. In case of rootstock, we have to check polyembryony, then screen for the diseases, go for compatibility, further evaluation, it will go rootstock. In case of cyan, just check the fruit, acceptable quality is there or not, our desirable genes have been transferred, then multiply it, go for next step. So these are all the protocol in case of citrus hybridization. So these are all the rootstock. We have developed NRCC 1 to 6 rootstock using Rafflemon and Troyer citric and trifoliate orange as a male parent. So these are all the reaction to the different Phytophthora strains. We have Phytophthora palmivora, Nicotiana. Some of things are tolerant to Phytophthora palmivora and susceptible to Nicotiana. Some of them tolerant to Nicotiana and susceptible to Phytophthora. These are all the plants. Again, you could have been studied trifoliate. This is one of the morphological character. If you cross, no need to again, one more step I forgot to tell. If you go for now, you have developed a hybrid progeny. So for hybrid progeny, we need to confirm through molecular markers whether it is a true hybrid or not. Even though you are isolating the embryo, at one point of time, all embryos look similar. So we don't know which embryo is isolated. After planting material have generated and successfully established, you have to go for molecular screening. Both parents as well as progeny, you have to check to confirm whether true hybrid is or not. And one such step you can avoid when you use a trifoliate orange. 100% if you trifoliate leaf will be there in the progeny. It is a hybrid. Now again, one more question is there. Farmers are highly adapted to our Rafflemon and Rangpur lime. Our basic idea is that our rootstock should look like Rafflemon and Rangpur lime so that they can have better adaptability of adaptability in our environmental condition. And one more thing, though you can see the trifoliate orange, Poncerus trifoliata, is highly resistant to many biotic and abiotic stresses, but its survival in Indian condition is very poor. In China, its cool climate, it performs exceptionally well. Nearly almost 90% of area under China is under trifoliate rooster. Almost 100% area in Japan is under trifoliate rooster. But if you take in our condition, this kind of very high clay soil and high temperature, it's not at all surviving. Initially, rootstock compatibility, both rootstock and cyan compatibility in Nagpur mandarin as well as sweet orange, Indian sweet orange, Mozambique is exceptionally good. But after 10 years, 15 years, suddenly it will become, plantation become decline and it will die. So long term, it will not sustain. And on the other side, our well-established two roots are Graflam and Rangpurlep. It's highly susceptible to drought as well as Phytophthora, greening, trichis, everything. So we are put under such a pressure that we have to improve these two varieties with the trifoliate gene, our desirable gene from the trifoliate. Again, one more undesirable character in trifoliate orange group, they are deciduous in nature. So they will fall, they will drop all the leaves during the winter. That character is not desired by the farmers. If the plantation drops all the leaves, immediately farmer mentality will go that your plantation is died. So we have to identify the rootstock having the blood of both Graflam or Rangpurlep with the trifoliate blood, and more character towards the Graflam or Rangpurlep. You see, there is no trifoliate leaf. These are all the confirmed hybrids with the blood of trifoliate. And it looks like the female parent. So this kind of hybrids we have to select. Then only this will be accepted for the farmers. So whenever if you go for any hybridization program, always keep in mind that it should go to the concerned customer. So who is our customer? Farmers are our customer. So what kind of varieties they need, that the way we have to give the hybrids to the farmers. Otherwise, it will be not at all acceptable. Even 100% resistant hybrid you develop and it will not be accepted by the farmer. So both the things you have to consider. Resistance also should be there and it should convince the farmers also. Then only hybridization will be succeeded in case of rootstock. So this is one of the trickiest thing we are facing in the perennial food crops. For example, one more thing I'm telling you. If you go to the market, your parents ask you to go some vegetables. You just go to the market, you ask 1 kg tomato I need or 1 kg brinjal I need. You give chilies. So we never bother about which hybrid or which variety that is. Generally, blankly, we will purchasing tomato or chili, whatever it may be. But in case of fruits, you go, I need only grand nand banana, I need only puvan banana, I need only challa chakrakali, or I need only your nei puvan, or I need alfonso mango. So in case of fruits, consumer preference will be there. So that is one of the drawback for any fruit breeders across the globe. We have to overcome all those problems. The breeders throughout the world, including our institute, our IHR, our CITH, you take your state agricultural universities there, all the fruit breeders, they are facing huge problem setback for this one, this consumer preference only. So whenever you go for releasing a variety, keeping in mind that who is your consumer, accordingly we have to release the variety. Then only we can able to succeed. Now you see that now we have rootstock. Okay, directly we cannot give to the farmers. First we have to go for what is our cyan Nagpur mandarin. You have to evaluate the performance of Nagpur mandarin on this particular rootstocks. Again, you have to go for your control check Graflam. So if you take plant aid, ultimately your Graflam generally a vigorous plant. So with the introduction of trifoliate, introgression of trifoliate blood, automatically the tree size will be reduced in the rootstock. This you can see apparently. And canopy volume. So both NRCC2 and NRCC5, they are having the acceptable level of the canopy volume. And so take fruit size. So NRCC5 rootstock is performing a little bit good. But overall the fruit yield you take, Graflam under NRCC3, they are on par. So this NRCC5 and NRCC3, these two rootstocks are at par performing with the Graflam with the enhanced quality of your resistant to Phytophthora. So this is the thing we need. And maybe it is only fifth year of evaluation. We have to evaluate another 5 more years. Then only we can give this thing for recommendation to the farmers. Mutation breeding. Why mutation breeding is required? We have a lot of varieties. So mutation breeding is required. What are the existing commercially cultivated citrus varieties which is lacking one or two traits? To improve that one or two traits in existing commercial varieties, we are going for mutation breeding. So here I am giving only rootstock picture. I have not given Siam. For Siam, two things are important. For Asylum group, we are working for canker resistant. In case of Mandarin and other groups, we are working for seedlessness. So these three we are working for Siam, and rootstock obviously it is phytophthora resistance. Okay, so this is again fourth year old. This year only we have came flowering and yield. So we have identified two mutants of Nagpur Mandarin with the seedless character, one Kinno Mandarin from as a seedless character, two Asylum with mild tolerant to canker. We have to further evaluate. Another one disadvantage in mutation breeding is their stability. Initially it may show seedlessness character, but subsequent year that character may fail. So we need stable mutant. That is, identifying the stable mutant is one of the important mutation breeding program in all the crops. That is why mutation breeding is very highly successful in case of flower crops, because in flower crops every 2 years your variety will be replaced. If you find the good color through mutation breeding, whether that variety is stable or not, no problem, just release. 1 or 2 years only, by the time another variety will replace that existing variety. So in floriculture crops it's highly successful. In perennial crops, because of the stability in nature, we are not able to find release lot of varieties. Recently Punjab Agriculture University, they have released one Kinno. I already told more than 23 seeds will be there in single fruit of Kinno. They have released, the Punjab PIU released. One should appreciate the PIU. They have come with one PIU Kinno one, which is having only less than 2 seeds, and it is highly stable and commercially released for farmers. 2 years back they have commercially released. So they worked for nearly 20 years the breeders put effort. After 20 years only, they were 20-25 years only the variety is coming out. So always respect your perennial crops breeder, and any crops, if a variety is coming, behind 10-15 years work will be there. Now coming to the production side, so disease free quality planting material, I already told. First thing is your potting mixture. Okay, if you take soil from the any block, wherever you are cultivating citrus, your soil is infested with phytophthora. Slowly phytophthora spreads. So in India, almost all our soils are infested with one or other species of phytophthora. So our citrus major problem is phytophthora. Your potting mixture should be free from phytophthora. So first option is fumigation. Fumigation will give best results, no question about that. But all the fumigants are toxic and carcinogenic in effect. So it's not at all advised. So we stop the fumigation. Second thing is go for steam sterilization. You can see some of the equipments are there for steam sterilization. So how much volume of soil you steam sterilize it? 100 kg, 200 kg, okay, you can go for sterilization in machineries. But if you go for 4 tons, 5 tons of soil material you have, how much power you need, how much manpower you need, how much time you need. So it's not feasible. Economically, it's not feasible. If you recommend this technology to any nurseryman, 100% they will not follow. So whenever you are recommending a technology to a nurseryman, it should be practically feasible. It should be practically adaptable. So one such method is just go for soil solarization. In central India, I already told temperature will reach up to 49 degrees Celsius. 49 degrees Celsius. So if you go for soil, sand, everything, you spread a layer, go with the transparent polythene sheet during March. March, April, May, June. When temperature soars up to 49 degrees Celsius outside the environment, inside heat will be trapped, so inside temperature will be more than 54 degrees Celsius. Again, how much height? We cannot heat the soil more, so heat, the temperature will not penetrate. With maximum 15 to 20 centimeter height only you have to keep the soil. Then only uniform temperature will be there. By 54 degrees Celsius, your most of harmful pathogens will be killed. This is the idea. So every year you have to follow point number one. And point number two, this is the rootstock. You have to go for primary nursery, then go for secondary nursery. Sorry, I forgot to put Siam. And roots are no problem. Seeds are virus free. Citrus, none of the citrus virus diseases are not transmitted by seed. So no question about virus in the seed. Already your soil media is solarized, free from pathogen, and you go for primary nursery. This is the primary and secondary nursery. Then go for cyan. So cyan, what we will do, we identify the other allied mother blocks, collect that cyan, bring it to tissue culture. Tissue culture develop, go for shoot tip grafting, both rootstock as well as cyan, both you grow in tissue culture. Go for shoot tip grafting and put it in the screen house so that your pathogen will not enter, any pest will not enter. These are thrips, your aphids, they are all carrier for different diseases. We can check every year before taking the budding season. Just go for randomly, you will check the five viruses: citrus greening, citrus tritisa, citrus, of course citrus greening is a bacterial disease, then citrus tritisa, citrus ring spot, then two more viruses are there, citrus mosaic and one more, I forgot. So these five pathogens we will test. Once it is clear only, we will take the bud stick and we will go for budding, particularly in Vidarbha region. We will go for November, December and first fortnight of January. This is the budding season. Once you go for budding, it will take 22 days to bud sprout. After 22 days, the bud start to sprout. Then after that, we have to keep for 6-7 months. So starting from seed sowing to selling, it will take 18 to 22 months. So that is the time period. And each cost of cultivation per plant is coming 150 rupees if you follow all the protocols. So nursery months, they are still failed to do all those practices. We are trying to tell them at least how to maintain the cyan block so that viruses cannot be transmitted through planting material. This way we are progressing. This is the planting material production. And our institute could not able to meet 1% demand of the country. So we are almost selling 4 lakh planting material and our plantation requirement is almost 1 crore. So we could able to sell only 4 lakh planting material. Then see, this is the way we are progressing every year. This is the sale of the different planting material production. Then coming for GAP, we standardize nutrient management for different crops, micronutrient management. Citrus is a nutrient level loving crop, both the major as well as micronutrient. Then irrigation, post-harvest techniques, we are all standardized. First fertilizer schedule for Nagpur mandarin, these are the first 3 years. Then after that, urea almost you need 1.3 kg, 1.2 kg single super phosphate and 180 gram MOP. These are all the recommendation after evaluating more than 10-15 years. And this is for acid line. This is blanket recommendation for Vidarbha region and water management. So citrus, actually we have to give stress. Two things are required. Low temperature, so less than 20 degrees Celsius is required for citrus flowering. Nagpur mandarin group of telling. Mandarin as well as sweet orange. So winter we are getting the low temperature, subsequently we will get flowering in January, February. That is called ambia flowering. Am means mango. So mango, when it will flower in January, February. That, so flowering coming in mango season, it is called ambia flowering. So ambia bahar. So in, you have studied enough for citrus, ambia bahar, bahar treatments. So ambia, that time always remember, am means mango. Mango flowering time, January, February. So flowering coincide during the mango flowering time is called ambia bahar, January, February. Second thing is mirg. Mirg in Maharashtra means monsoon. So when monsoon is starting in central India, June, July. Okay. So June, July flowering is called mirg bahar. So this is easy way of remembering, I am explaining you. Monsoon is called mirg in Marathi language. So mirg flowering is monsoon flowering, June, July. Am means mango in Hindi and Marathi both. Am means mango. Ambia flowering is your January, February flowering. Then Hasta bahar flowering is October. So January, February flowering based on your low temperature, less than 20 degrees Celsius is required. And we will go for withholding the water. So December, January, December we will give stress period. So December, no orchard will be irrigated. So we will induce the stress coupled with the low temperature, you will get flowering in January, February. And due to high temperature stress, then again you won't find any moisture. So that stress we will get June, July flowering. In case of Nagpur mandarin as well as Mosambi in central India. So these are all the irrigation requirement. than fruit drop. I already told citrus is more prone to fruit drop. So both pre-harvest as well as post-harvest fruit drops will be there. In case of pre-harvest, you will go immediately for 2-4 day, 15 ppm. Both pre-harvest as well as post-harvest, if it is not transmitted by any disease. Okay, so disease-induced fruit drops also there. Generally, we will recommend you go for 2-4 day or JA3 15 ppm with any one fungicide you spray. So it will take care of both fruit drops. Again, one should also clear that whether it's a normal fruit drop or excessive fruit drop. So lot of flowers will be there. Initially, fruit set will be so high. Over the time, fruits will drop. So that is called normal fruit drop. Okay. To avoid the crop load, your plant will shed some fruits. The excessive fruit drops will be there. That is due to some hormonal imbalance or any pest and disease attack. Or drought, your excessive fruit drop will be there. So one should always remember that fruit drop is due to normal in nature to balance the leaf shoot ratio, or excessive fruit drop by hormonal imbalance or disease. Based on that only we can go for spraying. Then we have developed nutrient management practices, irrigation management practices. This is the comparative study. If you go for conventional practice, you can find only 300 to 400 fruits in 10 to 10 years old plants. But if you go for particularly recommended fertilizer dose, fruit drop control, micronutrient management, you can go up to 800 to 1000 fruits. So you can get that first quality fruits, nearly 32% increases of first quality fruits over your traditional practice. Again, post-harvest degreening. You can see Nagpur mandarin will not get pure orange color here due to temperature. But if you go to Kasi mandarin bed, you can find pure orange color mandarins. But in central India, Kinnu again is a very perfect orange color will be there. But in central India, if you take any sweet orange or Nagpur mandarin, the green orange color will not be there. It's always blend with slight yellowish orange or green color will be there. Then we can go for degreening using ethanol. Several the post-harvest technologies. So now farmers, lot of earlier, whatever fruits farmers will harvest, they will just send to the market. Now many people are started a grading machine, they have purchased. So all farmers will come, they pay some rent and they will go for grading. Accordingly, they are sending now. So farmers also, they are using smart practices to get better price in the market. So big size fruits from Nagpur, they will send to Kolkata market, Chennai market, Mumbai, Delhi. And medium size fruits, they will sell it local. Small size fruits and medium will be sold at local. So see that how shrink wrapping technology, your cardboard boxes, this is grading machine. So according to the market, they will reduce the, go for grading. And this transparent polythene sheet packaging, polythene LDP sheets, it will reduce the transpiration, because the shelf life period under open condition for Nagpur mandarin is hardly 7 to 10 days. After that, shrinkage will be there, the juice quality will be affected, then slowly decay will start. Then you can go for shrink wrapping as well as anything, sir?
Sorry, sir, there is some other person. There is okay.
Then to avoid moisture loss and for distance marketing, this kind of packages are required. Then disease. First thing, phytophthora, these are all the symptoms. If it is coming in color, it's called color rot, root rot, these are all symptoms of phytophthora. This is the typical symptoms. You can see the gummosis. After that, slowly this plantation will die. So what do we have to do? First, affect that, scrap the disease portion. So this portion, you have to, wherever the gummosis is coming, you have to clear and dig it out, remove the bark, then go for either Ridomil paste you have to apply, and spraying of whole plant spraying also required, and drenching also required. So every year, immediately after harvest, we can go, two things one should do. Deadwood removal is very much important in case of citrus. Other crops, generally people will not, perennial crops I am telling, mostly they will not go for annual pruning, but in case of citrus, it is a necessary operation. Immediately after harvest, deadwood pruning is very much necessary. And wherever gummosis is there, immediately you go for these control measures. And before onset of monsoon, and whenever you observe the symptom, we have to take care of this thing. And one branch is affected, immediately you have to remove that that portion, then only you can, at least you can maintain that plant. Otherwise, slowly, if you will not take any control measure, it will die. See, yeah, before rainy season, border pest you have to apply up to this much height. So it will arrest. Already your soil is infested with the pathogen. When rainfall is there, that spillout will go and touch the trunk portion, there infection will start. So it is necessary to go for carbo border pest application, and this affected portion, see, you have to clear. After clearing, you have to clear like this, then go for your recommended fungicide pasting that particular zone. Again, our institute identified one Trichoderma acerinum strain isolated from the citrus orchard. So this strain give better effect for controlling the phytophthora. Again, this also, now whatever the seedlings we are producing here, we are pre-inoculating the this particular Trichoderma acerinum strain. You can also apply this strain in the trunk portion, and drenching also can be given. Second thing, scab. This is the scab disease. For management, prophylactic spray of captopril, binomyl, any fungicide we can give. And canker, mainly acylum you can find in leaf. This is the canker disease. See that close view. This is that canker. It will come leaf, stem, twigs, as well as fruits. See fruits in Assam lemon. And this is the easily controllable disease. Whenever humidity increases, we can go for carboxychloride 0.3%, coupled with on streptocycline spray 100 ppm. Okay, particularly February, October, December, you have to spray. This is a recommendation. We can easily control this citrus canker. Then greening. This is one of the major diseases in the world. Almost most of the citrus industry throughout the world is collapsing due to citrus greening. So this is the symptom. Exactly matching the nutrient deficiency. So people always, even sometimes we are also confused. No one can say exactly whether it is greening or nutrition deficiency. Continuous field visits are required, then only one can differentiate between the nutrient deficiency symptom as well as your greening symptom. You can see it exactly look like zinc deficiency. So how we can say this particular plant is affected by zinc deficiency or greening? Always citrus greening is sectorial. Any one branch or part of tree will be affected. In case of nutrition deficiency, whole tree will express the symptom uniformly. In case of greening, only that affected portion will express the symptom. Remaining area will look like normal plant. See the fruits, how fruits are elongated. Okay. These are all different symptoms. You can, earlier photo, you can see it look like zinc deficiency. Here you are seeing blotchy mottled symptom. Here you see the fruit elongation symptom. Once fruit is elongated, it cannot be marketed. Okay. So if you take the TSS, it hardly you can find 4 to 5 degree peaks TSS will be there. So that much reduction in your TSS will be there. Fruit is not at all palatable. And by seeing itself, it will be rejected in the market. So it is not at all saleable. Disease management, only disease management right now, we do not have any resistant rootstock, any resistant cyan. Exactly, it is your aphid control, sorry, psyllid control. It is Asian citrus psyllid is the vector. We have to control psyllid. Sweet orange is the indicator plant. We have to observe symptoms on sweet orange plants. It was recommended that you can inject tetracycline compost, and very difficult to inject, practically impossible. Suppose you have some 20 feet high tree. Any one branch you are getting that symptom, is it possible to go with syringe and inject a tetracycline? So practically impossible, but no other option available also, frankly speaking, for particularly this control of this disease. So, even in USA, they are continuously working on transgenes, CRISPR, but no success. Ultimately, wherever possible, they identified 2-3 rootstocks, Poncerus trifoliata a little bit, and Citrus latifolia. See, this is another one thing, in peculiar thing. We have a lot of genetic resources in India, a lot of wild species, but we do not know the importance of that one. Someone is evaluating, they identified that Citrus latifolia is highly resistant to citrus breeding. We did not know. Through literature only we came to that our own species is resistant to your greening disease. Badly, it's not compatible with citrus, so we are trying to introduce it's not surviving in Nagpur condition. We are trying to bring pollen from there to pollinate. Its pollen is trying. We are working on it. And meanwhile, we are trying to use Citrus latifolia as a rootstock. That work also going on, not only in India. Recently, we have started. Italy has already started. They use Citrus latifolia as a parent. They come with one hybrid rootstock also. And US, if you take wherever possible, they went for a trifoliate orange rootstock. The better control along with better nutrient management. Now, if you see Florida, if you go, Florida, University of Florida website, if you go, they have 10-15 research project on how to manage the greening affected orchards through better nutrient and irrigation management. Okay, so better nutrient and better drainage as well as irrigation facility, we can get good crop even though we have greening. That is the only option available right now. Second thing is that budwood subrogation program. If the orchard is affected by greening, you should not take budwood. Otherwise, continuously that greening pathogen will spread over the year. Almost the entire India will be affected by greening. It will completely destroy the citrus industry in the country. So again, I told budwood subrogation program, pruning every, that dead portion should be pruned. Once you prune next tree, you have to disinfect that particular, even next branch also. You have to go for dipping sodium hypochlorite solution so that you can avoid the movement of the bacteria. Another pest, if you take general pest, what are the pests you take? There are four categories: sucking pest, foliage feeders, fruit feeding, stem feeders. Okay. Bark eating caterpillar, it's only nuisance in Northeast India. Remaining all pests, it's common for throughout India. Okay. Black fly, this is the only reason CCRA has come in Nagpur. White flies, not that much big issue. Citrus illa, I told, this is a notorious pest spreading in our greening world. And aphids and thrips, these are all the vectors for our other viruses. Mealybugs, foliage feeder, leaf miner, highly you can find. Citrus butterfly, these are all foliage feeders, okay, attacking the fruit. Remaining all your larval stage, any fruit, any crop you take, 99% case only larval or nymph stage will affect the crops. Only few insects will affect in adult stage. Bark eating caterpillar, this is also again larval stage only will affect that. The larva will bore into the trunk, it will make holes and it will affect your phloem xylem movement. Ultimately, that particular affected portion will dry. Mites, these are all nymph stage. And the fruit fly and fruit fly piercing moth, these are the two adult pests. Particularly when color break is there, see the time of infection. When color break is there, they will come and puncture. Immediately, that affected portion will rot in couple of days. In 2-3 days, it will rot and fruits will drown. It causes huge economical loss. So to control these things are very much important. See, this is a black fly. These are all the control measures, acephate, imidacloprid, dimethoate. White fly, almost same systemic insecticide only will come, white fly. And this is Citrus silla, you can see adult. This is the nymph. This stage is the transmitted stage. And aphids, you can see downward curling. If you, this downward curling of leaves, it will be your aphids only. By distance itself, we can see. And again, this pest, the sucking pest will come only whenever new flush emergence. January, February or June, July, this time only new flush will come. That time only this pest will come. Whenever you see a citrus orchard, your leaves are downward curling, this is the pest for aphids. And thrips, it is upward curling. See, downward curling, it is the aphids, and it's upward curling, this is thrips. I already told the symptom. This is the stage. You can see immediately after fruit set, very small size, your pea size fruits will be there. That time this your thrips will attack. This is the mature fruit. You can see all damaged portion will, you can, it will be visible, and ultimately the market value will be come down. And leaf miner, this symptom, I think most of you could have been missed. These are all the neem oil also will give better control for this leaf miner. And mites, you can see this is copper irate symptom. Typical mite symptom, if you cannot be able to control during the flushing time mites, this symptom will appear. Your market price will come to 70% less price you will get. So drastically, and moreover, that skin will become tight, juice content will be less. So this is the typical symptom of mites. Okay, here vegetable sulfur, dicofol are there, I think it's banned. Now we are trying for this. is there a new generation might decide give better results. Fruit Sekhima, this is the moth. You can see night time in this picture, you see this moth is taking the juice. Again, alternate host. So identification of alternate host. So all larval pathogen will be in these beets. When become adult, they will come for citrus fruits. And only night time this will come. So going night time, controlling this insect will be very less. Again, insecticide spray also you cannot spray because color break stage is affecting. And couple of 10-15 days without harvest, so insecticide spray also is not recommended. So we are trying with horticulture mineral oil, so it will give some repellent effect so that we can avoid this pest. And we are institute is continuously working on traps so that we can attract the adults instead of attacking the fruits. These adults are attracted with our attractants so that we can collect that adults, reduce the incidence. You can see how this puncture. This way it will make puncture and immediately this portion will drop and all fruits will fall down. And this is fruit fly. Fruit fly also same. It will puncture and the rotting will be there. See, this is the fruit fly affected portion. This is the trap, fruit fly trap. Methyl eugenol chemical based loose we are preparing. And bark eating caterpillar. Dichlorovast is the only available pesticide which can give control. Recently dichlorovast is banned. Okay, now entire citrus industry is blank to control this pest. So again we are trying to work out new generation insecticide to control this thing. So this is the way we have identified that this particular excreta portion, remove it, and in holes it will be inside. So externally spraying of fungicide is not at all work. So we can inject that dichlorovast solution. Now it's banned, so I cannot commercially recommend it's banned. For your knowledge purpose only I am telling. That's why I am repeatedly informing you this is banned chemical, we should not recommend. We are trying for other kerosene. Right now kerosene will give some effect. Because of fumigation this larva will die, kerosene or petrol. Again controlling also very difficult. So only right now is available practice is collect that adults will come out during the July, August, September, 3 months only. In 3 months, maximum adult, just shake the tree, collect the adult, kill it. And go for petrol injection, plug the hole. These are the two measures right now we are having in hand. And we have, this is our website, anytime you can visit. And this is our CCR Citrus app, you can download. You can have all that information over it. Now it's open for discussion.
So thank you very much, sir. For covering the in-depth of the activities of the Central Institute of Citrus. For in-depth, the students have got very in-depth knowledge about the citrus. So now it is a time for discussion. So please, students who are having any doubts, sir is with us. You can post questions either in chat box or directly you can ask orally. Sir, one question is in the chat box.
Yes.
What are the latest works on extracting bioactive compounds from citrus?
Sir, right now our institute is working on flavonoids, to extract flavonoids and limonids. These two we are extracting, sir. Flavonoids and limonids.
Thank you, sir. Next, one more question. Does citrus plant...
Only one more information, sir. Again, in commercially available species, it's very difficult to extract. So it will go to market. So what we are doing is that dropped fruits. So over the course of time, a fruit drop will be there. From that dropped fruits, we already standardized the technology. Dr. Dinesh Kumar has standardized the technology to extract these flavonoids from the dropped fruits. And one company has taken up the technology. They are extracting that one. They are commercially doing.
Sir, one more question. Thank you, sir. One more question, sir. Does citrus plant can be effective as nanopesticides?
Which one, sir?
Does citrus plant can be effective as nanopesticides?
Nanopesticides?
Sir. It is a question.
We are not working, sir. We are nanopesticides. Till now, we are not working. Because for that company, people has to come. They have to give their product here for evaluation. And most of that, lot of... better pesticides and fungicides are available, new generation fungicides. But officially we cannot recommend because they are not having label claim. So to recommend those, fungicides or pesticides, they have to get labeled there. Until they came forward officially, we cannot, not only citrus, any state agricultural university or central university or research institute, they cannot recommend. So label claim is missed.
Is there any questions? Is there any questions, students, please? Sir, one more question from Mayur.
Yes, sir.
Depollution of citrus.
Yes, sir.
Aurantium flowers before its hydrodistillation.
I'm not getting, sir. Yeah.
Sir, one more question from in the chat box. Depollution of citrus or Aurantium flowers before its hydrodistillation. The question is like this only, sir.
One minute, sir. Chat box.
Can you please check in the chat box, sir? The question is like this.
1 minute, sir. Chat. Depollution of citrus aurantium flowers before hydrodistillation. Sir, I could not get that exact question.
Yes, sir. Mayura, please, you can ask orally. Since the question is not clear, okay, yeah. Sir. One more question from Sangali.
So, acid lime, lemon. Acid lime is citrus aurantiumfolia. Lemon is citrus limon. Generally, we used to call lemon. So, it's a vague term. What are the round fruits? Small round fruits. Colloquially, I'm telling for your general identification. Small round fruits available in the market. They are all acid limes. Okay. 1 minute. I just show the difference. Slides are visible, sir?
Yes, sir. Visible, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, this is this fruit. This kind of round fruits, small round fruits, you can see the flesh color also. These are all acid limes. In case of lemon, lemons are little bit bigger in size. Nipple. You can see here that nipple is not prominent. But in case of lemon, nipple will be prominent. Round shape also will be there, elongated shape also will be there. Okay. So small round size fruits are acid lime, bigger in size with the prominent nipple, they are lemons. Point number one. Okay. In plant, lime have white color flower. Then lemon is having pink color flower. Lime is having little bit tree. And lemon will look like sherb. Acid lime will take nearly 4 years to come for flowering. Lemon will come in 6-7 months or within 1 year flowering will come. Any lemon fruits are there. This is the color you can see, flesh color. So lemon will be almost greenish tinge will be there, and lemon lemon color will be slightly orangish color. Second thing, acidity. So acid lime acidity will be around almost 6%, lemon will be around 4%. So acid limes are high in acid, lemons are less in acid. These are all the some basic differences.
The next question, sir, is there any research going on propagation method by cuttings? Chat box.
Sir, acid lime, it's completely seed, because the seed is free from virus. Moreover, we can nucellus embryos are there. So acid lime only is having high amount of polyembryony. Generally, we go for seed and we will prepare vigorously growing seedlings. That is 99.99% is from nucellus embryo. It's true to type. And budding also now, particularly if you go Andhra Pradesh private nurseries, they are going for budding. Using randomly available, whatever the rootstock available, they are going. But I don't know long term effect, bud breakage also will be there. But acid lime is concerned, seed is sufficient. In case of Nagpur mandarin, for mother block, we are using shoot tip grafting. In general, there are two methods are there. One is normal budding, another one is micro budding. So micro budding, very early stage, nearly 6-7 month old rootstock will go for budding, and your bud size will be very thin, very small. So only highly specialized person only can go for micro budding, and your nursery period also will be reduced in case of micro budding. Budding bud size will be big, and 1 year old rootstock will do. So micro budding and normal budding, this tea budding, these two are commercially we are following in case of mandarin, sweet orange, pomelo and grapefruit. Lemon generally cuttings will do, seeds also will do.
And one more question, sir. How about organic approach in citrus, as now organic industry is on bloom? Shall I repeat once again, sir? Question from Bhagya.
Yeah, one more time you repeat, sir, question.
How about organic approach in citrus, as now organic industry is on bloom?
Sir, organic, it's a catchy word. Practically, I'm speaking.
Okay, sir.
You can say organic, but who is the customer? You cannot, until unless you sell it in very high price, you will not get profit. Badly, if you go market, there is no differentiation between organic and inorganic. Again, organic in long time, particularly citrus, it will not sustainable. So if you go for integrated nutrient management, only thing you can reduce the inorganic fertilizer and go for more organic sources, you can get the better results. We have also developed organic package of practices. Organic package of practices are ready, but it depends on how farmers are effectively managing. Otherwise, if you will not go for proper irrigation, organic source of nutrients, I'm telling organic package doesn't mean that you are not applying nutrient. So organic source of nutrient, you have to give rock phosphate, you have to give now lot of organic micronutrients came. So all you have to apply. If you apply all source, then industry can supply. But purely depending on your vermicompost and cow dung, it will not sustain.
Okay, so next question is, which is mostly preferred bahar in citrus?
Ambia bahar is general, particularly Nagpur man, it's Mirbahar is mostly preferred because of better price and better quality, but Mirbahar flowering will be very less. So you can see 60% 70% Ambia bahar will be there. Ultimately fruit will come in winter time. Okay, glut will be there, price will be less. But if you get Mirbahar, because lot of efforts would be, you have to put, without affecting the plant, lot of effort you have to give, expose that root. Then climate also you have to favor for Mirbahar. Earlier Nagpur we will get Mirbahar flowering, now we are not getting, only Madhya Pradesh now it's coming. So climate, your management practices coupled with the drought induction time. If you get Mirbahar is the best. You will get high price, high quality price of fruits, because you will get fruit in March. So when temperature is high, where you need more juice or refreshing fruits, it exactly will come on that time. March you will get Mirbahar fruits. ROS, I am telling, coming to market. So Mirbahar is the preferred one, but practically Ambia bahar is the available one.
Okay, so next one, sir. Question from Pratima Biradar. What is the best and cost effective method for extracting essential oil from citrus peel?
I have no idea, sir. Only I would encourage Dinesh, sir. Because still in research, citrus peel oil under only research stage only. Commercially, still we have not commercialized.
Nidhi, variety suitable for making. Next question, sir. One more next question from Nidhi student. Nidhi name. A variety suitable for making lemonade drink.
Any acid lime or lemon, sir, will do. There is no variety specific. It is species specific.
And she is asking for last production, sir.
Species, again, I am telling you, it's not variety specific, it is species specific. Acid lime or lemon, suitable for lemon.
Okay, sir. And another question from Naveen. Brief on oleocellulosis, sir.
Oleocellulosis, I have no idea, sir. This question I will get you, sir, back.
Okay, sir. And next question from one more student, name not known, but can you explain about bahar?
Bahar system I already explained, sir.
Okay.
January, February flowering is Ambia bahar.
Yes, sir.
June, July is Mirb bahar. Ashta bahar is October. These three times you can get flowering, but generally 90% case you will get only Ambia flowering. Mirb bahar, you have to induce the flowering.
Open hour.
Naturally, you will get Ambia flowering, no question about that. Because low temperature is there, winter you will go for stop the irrigation. Due to low temperature, January, February, flowering will come, no question. Throughout the country, you will get flowering. Nirbahar, you have to induce. You have to give stress. After that, immediately you have to apply copious water and climate also. That time it should not rain. If it is rain, you will not get flowering. So these factors favor, you will get Mirbahar. So Mirbahar you have to induce. Astabahar is difficult to get. Only acid lime you will get. Acid lime and lemon you will get Astabahar. In Nagpur mountain and sweet orange you will not get.
Okay, is there any questions? Sir, one more question from Bhagyasri.
Yeah.
What all post harvest products have being developed from your institute?
So we have commercialized using Nagpur mandarin juice. We have commercialized the technology for ice cream making and one burfi. If you come central India, some burfi is highly famous. So using that, they use synthetic flavor called Santra Burfi. Whenever you just pass the train and stay in Nagpur station, you will flood it like Agra, how they will give Agra Pata, and Nagpur they will give Santra Burfi. So it's synthetic flavor. So institute, using the natural juice, we have commercialized the technology. Santra Burfi is in natural juice. And citrus, acid lime RTS, red to serve, commercialized. And then metal secondary, some flavonoid extraction, they have commercialized. And 2-3% some citrus peel, they made some products. So nearly 5-6 technologies have commercialized, and one isolation technology for some essential oil or secondary metabolites recently got patent. Just our institute foundation day on July 16th, we got one patent. This year, July 16th, 2021, we got one patent for process extraction method for some secondary metabolites. Exactly, I don't know the information. So our post-harvest department got one patent. So nearly 6-7 products already commercialized, sold to the industry. Only industry selling, I am telling. One is citrus acid lime juice, RTS, Nagpur mandarin, this one RTS, and Santra Burfi. One more thing, some product I forget. So 7 products they have already marketed.
Yes, sir, another question. Any post-harvest product of acid lime?
Acid lime RTS. RTS and pickle.
Okay.
Commercialist. Okay. I'm telling commercialist. RTS is commercialist, pickle also commercialist.
Okay. Another question, sir. Any research is going on?
Yes, sir. We are working. There is in acid lime, problem is harvesting because of tannin nature. So our acid lime tannless variety is required. PDK via cola, they identified one tannless variety called Chakradhar. But it's very, very shy flowering, shy bearing, it's failed. We are also working a thornless variety through mutation breeding because no other, we don't have source. If you develop any trait specific variety, we need a source. So in case of thornless, we do not have any source. So only option is that mutation breeding. That's why I already told commercially available varieties with 1 or 2 lakh, we can improve that particular variety through mutation breeding. So through mutation breeding in acid lime, we are working on thornless varieties.
One more question from Ibrahim. Major problems in cultivation of Nagpur mandarin or sweet orange?
Nagpur mandarin planting material, so availability of good quality planting material, drought, phytophthora. These are all the major problem right now. Slowly, right now greening is affecting only sweet orange, and now we are finding symptoms of greening in Nagpur mandarin also. Maybe in couple of years, greening also will create major problem in Nagpur mandarin. In case of sweet orange, particularly central India, would take this is Mozambique. If you go to Punjab, that is Malta. And if you go to South India, it is Satguri. These 3 areas, all areas are affected by drought. So drought and phytophthora, you can find earlier almost nearly 80,000 hectares are there. 80,000 hectares in only Andhra Pradesh. Now it's drastically coming to 20,000 hectares only because of drought. So drought is the major limiting factor for sweet orange in case of abiotic stress. In case of biotic stress, it is phytophthora and as well as greening. Kinno mandarin, next question. Kinno mandarin, we have not released. Kinno mandarin, actually, it is developed by USA way back in 1906 somewhere. Then 1951 to 52, Dr. Bakshi from Punjab to Dehradun University. 1930s, 1940, we have introduced. 1945, that time they have introduced, but after partitioning of the country, that particular Punjab went to Pakistan. So again, Reebok, it was introduced by Dr. Pakshi from PIU during 1955 or 56. He introduced in Kinno. And in 2018 or 2019, they have Kinno again, PIU again released one seedless Kinno through gamma irradiation, bud stick irradiation. They have irradiated using gamma rays the buds, then they went for budding. After that, they evaluated recently, 2018 or 19, I don't know exactly, they have released PIU Kinno membrane, seedless membrane. Pomelo and grapefruit, arid zones, semi-arid zones, no, not possible. Somewhere one orchard is there in Gujarat, but only one orchard. Generally, it is not recommended for these zones because you need rainfall, water, and this area is characterized by high saline sites. So these are all the factors with limit. But till now, no orchards. We are not evaluated also. I cannot blankly say not at all possible. One or two orchards in Gujarat also there, and part of Rajasthan also they are cultivating. So overall, generally I can say it's not recommended. Generally not recommended. Why acid lime is more popular? Acid lime is if you need juice, okay, either lemon or acid lime. One is juice, another one is pickle. These are the two predominant factor for these two varieties. So for pickle also we need more acid content. For juice also we need more acid content. So in lemon we don't have that much acid content. Okay, acid content is less in lemon, high in acid lime. That's why acid lime is much famous in India. But if you go in other countries, they need less acid. If you Western countries as well as US, they need less acid content. And lemon is popular in those countries. Otherwise, climate wise, both will perform better in Indian condition. In if you take Central India, high hot condition you take in Central India, it's performing well. If you go to Northeast India, high rainfall and high humid zone, there also it's performing. If you go to North India, typical winter is there also it's performing, no issue. Only thing is consumer preference. Our preference is going towards the acidity. So that's why lemon is not more popular. But some of the areas, particularly in Uttarakhand, they are cultivating lemon, commercially cultivating. I mean, commercially they are cultivating. Uttarakhand, Raipur, but in Chhattisgarh, they are finding marketability issue. Uttarakhand and Delhi market, they are lemon is having market.
Is there any questions? Okay, if no questions, thank you, sir. You made our students a citrus specialist because they have asked many questions and they have become expert in that, sir.
Yeah, a lot of questions, sir. Really, I am also happy.
Yes, sir. Questions they asked. Many questions you asked.
One more question. Somebody asked how to differentiate lime and lemon, and they forgot to ask how to differentiate pomelo and grapefruit because exactly they look similar. By plant, if you take pomelo, if you take the shoot, young shoot, if you closely observe, a lot of what is called small spines will be there. Trichomes, white color trichomes will be there in case of pomelo. That will typically absent in grapefruit because grapefruit is having parentage of sweet orange and pomelo. Okay, so the sweet orange character is acquired. The trichomes will absent in grapefruit. It will be present in our pomelo. That is the clear cut difference between the pomelo and grapefruit. Otherwise, both looks similar in case of tree morphology. Both fruits are flowers are big. Fruits also 500 gram will come. And again, if you cut the fruit, then only you can find the difference between the fruit. If you cut, hollow core will be there for pomelo, solid core will be there for grapefruit. Then juice vesicle is dry in case of pomelo, juicy in case of grapefruit. These are all the basic difference between the pomelo and grapefruit.
Yes. Thank you, sir. If no more questions, sir, now it's the time to give vote of thanks. Now I request...
One more point I forgot the other time.
Oh, okay, sir, please.
So, gene sanctuary, you can find tiger sanctuary, elephant sanctuary, rhinoceros sanctuary, lot of sanctuaries are there. We have one sanctuary for crops, okay? That is for citrus. Citrus gene sanctuary is there. I don't know how many of you know. You should know. Citrus gene sanctuary is established in Garo Hills of Meghalaya. So Meghalaya, there will be three hills, Khasi Hills, Jhenke Hills, Garo Hills. So Garo Hills, we have established citrus gene sanctuary only to protect citrus indica. This is the primitive species and highly undisturbed species because all other citrus will come flowering in January, February, June, July. your trifoliate will come from in March, April. But this particular species will come flowering entirely off season. It will go either May or in August. So it never have a chance to mix with other crops. But recent study also find that earlier their country just they thought that this is totally different species. Now they are also telling that it may be hybrid derivative of any other citrus genomes. But they don't have access to planting material, still it's there. And highly exploited wild citrus species. Almost 8 to 10 gram only fruits will be there. That 8 to 10 gram single fruit will sold around 10 rupees per fruit in market. Mainly they used for medicinal purpose. Citrus indica, 8 to 10 gram only, pure orange color will be there. Fruit will come in August, September in Meghalaya, only in Khasi Hills, sorry, Garo Hills. No other place. Somewhat recently, last year, some indica type plants have been reported in Manipur. Maybe someone have taken the planting material. And again, some nearly Pasigal, where horticulture, Central Agriculture University's horticulture college is there. They also, in wild, they found citrus indica. Maybe they are relocated from Garo Hills only. Otherwise, it is indigenous to Garo Hills only. Endemic to Garo Hills, I can say endemic to Garo Hills. So we have established a citrus gene sanctuary to protect citrus indica in Northeast India. Only gene sanctuary for crop.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Now I request our final students, Kaushik PM, to express what of thanks to sir. Great, sir. I thank to our college for giving an opportunity to do vote of thanks on behalf of our University of Horticultural Sciences, Bagalkot. I hereby convey heartfelt thanks to Dr. A. Thiruganavel, scientist of fruit science from the very esteemed Institute Central Citrus Research Institute, Nagpur. Thanks for sharing your valuable time and useful information with us. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. I think all the best for your JRF exam. I think yet to come, na?
Sir. September.
All the best. Prepare well and attempt well.
Okay, sir. And finally, I thank all the All India Study Tour coordinators and students of different horticulture colleges for their active participation and making today's program success. Thank you all.
Thank you very much. Any doubt, you can contact me through this email ID. I will put in chat box.
Yes.
This is my email ID and phone number. You can contact me at any time for any doubt in regarding citrus.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for spending your valuable time, sir.
Sir, I need some information from you. You can mail me or WhatsApp me, sir.
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
How many colleges attended? College-wise number of students, sir.
Okay, sir.
For our last foundation members.
Okay, sir. I will mail you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, sir. So now for the information of the students for tomorrow's session. Tomorrow we are having session at 11 a.m. 11 a.m. to 12:30 a.m. 12:30 p.m. From NBSS LUP, National Bureau of Soil Survey and Land Use Planning, Bengaluru. Dr. Rajendra Hegde, Regional Head, will be speaking, will be giving the orientation about the institute. So please be sharply, be ready at 11 o'clock. Thank you, Randall.